Support for LAist comes from USC's renowned Gould School of Law. Earn your Master of Studies in Law, a law degree for any professional in every industry. Enhance your career credibility with an essential legal education. More at gould.law/MSL.
I'm Julia Paskin. Join me as I talk with NPR's Sarah McCammon about her new book, The Ex-Evangelicals, Loving, Living, and Leaving the White Evangelical Church. That's April 25th at the Crawford. Tickets at las.com/events.
LAS Studios.
Hey LA, I'm Brian De Los Santos, and this is How to LA. Today, we're saying goodbye to a space with a storied legacy in this city, the Conga Room. The Latin music venue opened in 1998 with Cuban singer Celia Cruz headlining. For 25 years, the nightclub brought in artists ranging from Celia Cruz to Tito Puente to Maluma and Bad Bunny. I went for the first time in 2011. I was about 21 with a group of friends, and we were ready to take on the night. There was a huge line. It was really popping. We danced salsa all night, and everybody went home drenched in sweat, even though people had dressed to the nines. It was a spot in LA. The club's star-studded list of investors included J-Lo, Sheila E, comedian Paul Rodriguez, and actor Jimmy Smits. My coworker Cynthia Covarrubias remembered visiting the Conga Room's original location on Miracle Mile before it moved to downtown LA's LA Live in 2008.
It was the late 90s. J-Lo or Jennifer Lopez was, like, you know, blowing up. And it was just like the jewel of the community. I'd been going to the Mayan for salsa dancing. I was taking salsa lessons at the time. So going to the Conga Room was like a big deal. You know, you see like Sheila E. and all the greats playing there. Some folks would be dressed to like just dance all night. You had your professional dancers or your people in the dance community who were just there to dance. So a lot of times I was just there to watch other people like really dance salsa.
This week, the Conga Room is closing its doors. The legacy of the club will live on through a nonprofit called Conga Kids, a program bringing music and dance of the African diaspora to classrooms across LA. But it is still the end of an era. One of the Conga Room's original investors, Jimmy Smits, talked with me about the club's legacy. I'm going to ask you this interesting, weird question, but if you could answer it with the most descriptive language you can use. If you had to tell someone...
Without cursing.
Yes, that too. No, you could... Hey, this is a podcast. We can curse on it if you want to.
Okay.
If you had to tell someone who might have lived under a rock what the Conga Room was, how would you describe it?
The Conga Room was a venue in Los Angeles where Latin music, Latinx, Latino, where our music and our cultura thrived. And for 25 years, we were able to give Los Angeles a panorama of different types of Latin music. And I got just great memories of acts that have come through our stages. And I'm, you know, kind of sad that it's coming to a close.
Yeah, I know a lot of people are. You know, what made it special in your eyes? What was the spark that made you want to invest in time and money? What was it, the special thing in your eyes?
I guess the major thing is to give our culture meaning, sharing music, which just transcends everything. Give it to the Los Angeles community. And I think through the years we were able to do that on any given night. In either of the iterations of the venues, because we started out on Wilshire Boulevard in an old Jack LaLanne health club, and then moved over here to LA Live. But on any given night, you could come and listen to Mexican regional music, or a Thursday Tropical night where you listen to have salsa dancers, you know, reggaeton, Bad Bunny and J Balvin and, you know, Evie Queen. So many reggaeton artists graced our stages in the beginnings of their careers. Mm-hmm. So it's been beautiful to be able to share all that.
You know, I love the story that people who may have not been raised in L.A. like yourself, you're from New York and mm-hmm. with Puerto Rican roots, they still made the Conga Room a thing in L.A. And I, you know, I, for one, I went to the Conga Room at least three times in my life. And, you know, I'm 33. I didn't experience it in the OG place. I definitely went to L.A. Live three times.
I gotcha.
It was a great time. I felt like Latinidad was there. How would you say it served LA communities specifically? Because yes, worldwide acts would come in and they would probably bring in the fans from other regions of the world, other regions of the country, but it was here in LA. And how did that serve our gente?
Well, our gente was able to see in a very kind of intimate setting acts that their parents grew up seeing and that they were now seeing in a beginning sort of way in terms of reggaeton music and bachata and all of that. You know, it's just sharing a cultura. And that has been a beautiful thing.
Coming up, more of my conversation with actor Jimmy Smits about the closing of the Conga Room. Stay tuned.
Support for LAist comes from USC Gould School of Law, the first law school in Southern California, renowned for its history of excellence and innovation. Elevate your career with our Master of Studies in Law, a versatile degree for professionals in every industry. With online, on-campus, and hybrid formats, USC Gould offers flexibility to fit your schedule. Specialize in areas like business, entertainment, HR, healthcare, compliance, finance, and cybersecurity. Learn more at gould.law/MSL.
Hey, what's up, y'all? I'm Pendarvis Harshaw, host of the Right Nowish podcast. Every week, I talk to the people who are creating art and culture and spreading it to the universe.
As an artist, you always meet yourself. Every year, you're a different person.
Essentially, we normalize a space where you can show up as your authentic self.
Check out Right Nowish. Rooted in California's Bay Area, speaking to you.
It's so many people of color, so many queer people. It's like I'm being celebrated in my fullness.
Available wherever you listen to podcasts.
I kind of want to talk about the beginning. I want to know why and how did you get involved?
It's about sharing our culture. And yeah, you said that I came from New York, but I think that one of the beautiful things about being here in Los Angeles is that we have openings and we're available to all of, you know, you look at the name of the city, Los Angeles, right? And Latinidad is all over.
I love that. Thank you for sharing that. I do have to ask, you know, why it's closing?
Well, in terms of the tropical genre, of course, musical tastes have changed. But the pandemic, you know, hit us hard. So, I mean, that has a lot to do with it. I think about, like, going to a mom-and-pop bodega or grocery store or a hardware store that where you can see, you can get something very kind of, like, specific. And now we're into, like, you know, these huge venues and, you know, times change. And one glimmer that I have is that Brad Gluckstein, our managing partner here, we're into this thing called the Conga Kids, which is serving many Los Angeles school with bringing music and culture to young people. So it's like another generation, passing down to another generation.
Yeah, I think seeing, I don't know if you heard about The Last Repair Shop that just won an Oscar for Best Documentary Short.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And just seeing how not just, the big artists and the people in front of the stage, but also the people behind the stage, it's also the kids, the young adults, the youth who are up and coming, and how they become vibrant members of society, and also the arts. My memory of the Conga Room is like something festive, something fun. How would you say the legacy of the Conga Room lives on with that celebration of culture, maybe with even the nonprofit of the Conga Kids?
I mean, it'll live on because the music lives on, and music transcends everything. So in that sense, it'll definitely continue just because of the physical space is not here. But yeah, and you know, look at our population numbers. We're all over. And you think about some of the most successful musical acts in this past couple of years have been Latinos are presente all over.
I'm going to put you in the hot seat right now.
Yeah, bro.
And I kind of want you to dig in a little bit in your memory and tell me, mm-hmm. what's your favorite performance or event? I want to hear about that important memory you have where it's like, was it meeting Shakira backstage? Was it Celia Cruz? My personal favorite would have been Bad Bunny because I'm a huge fan. But what is your favorite performance or event at the Conga Room?
Well, I wish I could just tell you one, but there's a plethora of the plethora of things that come through my mind. Of course, Celia Cruz and Tito Puente. Celia actually opened the original Conga Room space. Gilberto Santa Rosa, who's going to be here when we do our closing ceremony, has been a staple through the years. But then I remember things like, you know, Prince played here at one point. Sheila E is involved with us, who is just releasing a Latin album. Sheila's just releasing a Latin album in the coming weeks. But we've done a lot of things community-wise. I remember meeting Desmond Tutu. We did a fundraiser for many political and social causes here. But the musical nights have been just like breathtaking. You get 1,100 people in a room listening to some beautiful Latin sounds. It's, you know, it's going to be more than lively. I just see happy faces. I love the fact that the traditional thing that you get to see when you go see Latin music venues is that inevitably the performer will talk about the different banderas. And, you know, so there'll be shout outs to the different countries.
A ver, Colombia, los colombianos, guatemaltecos, hondureños, mexicanos.
To have people from everywhere shouting out, saying Mexico, Puerto Rico, or Cuba, or Panama, it just brings joy to me, and a little bit of sadness because, you know, 25 years, this era is going to be over, but the music lives on.
I love that. All right, Jimmy, thank you so much for your time. We'll be catching you next time.
Thank you, and much respect for all that you do, bro.
I appreciate you. Thank you for coming.
Keep sharing.
I appreciate it. Gracias.
Gracias.
That was Jimmy Smits, actor and original investor of the Conga Room. There's a big closing party on Wednesday night, March 27th, where folks will say goodbye to the beloved venue one last time. But as Jimmy said, the nonprofit Conga Kids lives on, offering dance classes and music to students in 14 school districts across LA. Plus, there's more to the story on las.com/howtoLA. Go check that out. This episode was produced by Victoria Alejandro and Monica Bushman. Support for this podcast is made possible by Gordon and Donna Crawford, who believe that quality journalism makes Los Angeles a better place to live.
Oscar Gomez was a Chicano student activist in the 90s, a radio DJ, and a rising star.
He was fire. He was charisma incarnate. Everyone had a crush on him.
He was a voice of people who didn't have a voice.
Until his sudden and mysterious death. What happened to Oscar? Imperfect Paradise, The Forgotten Revolutionary, wherever you get your podcasts.